Hello and welcome. Today I'm going to show some of the new features of the RAW 2 version 33.0. To give a small overview of all the changes, let's have a look at the headlines first. First of all, there has been a revision of the graphical user interface to give a better overview and make a unification of the windows. There is a new presentation mode, which gives alternative representations and a lot of additional possibilities for the documentation. Also, there has been unification of the documentation, which allows to integrate a whole lot more things in the documentation. And there has been many small changes to increase efficiency, such as automatic checking of results and calculating without lift-up supports. But first, there has been a major revision of the graphical user interface. The goal was to simplify the interface so that there is a better overview and also to make the structure more unified. There is many similar functions that now have been regrouped, such as inner outer supports and different types of couplings. If necessary, the additional menus were introduced. There is also an optimization of the screen utilization for the presentation. The output window and the calculation window are only useful during the calculation itself, therefore they can now be hidden when there's not currently a calculation running. Anyway, the output is always available in the result window. Another new feature is that now the background color can be changed under the general setting presentation window, and it can be changed for the normal view and also for the new presentation mode. So let's get a little bit more into the details and have a look at the toolbar supports. We can see that from the previous version to the new version, a lot of support symbols have been removed. All the rigid supports, external and internal supports, have now been regrouped under the support symbol. And the same is true for the internal and external rigid hangers. As both external and internal hangers or supports share a lot of information and only have a slight difference, they are all now regrouped in the same window. And you can choose in the window if you want to do an external hanger and the internal hanger. For the internal hanger, you have to specify in addition the base point and the property of the auxiliary member. So let's have a look in the split screen mode. On the left side we have the old version 32.1, on the right side we have the version 33.0. And now let's assume we want to change this external hanger and connect it here to the structural steel. In 32.1 version we would use the internal support symbol, click on the node 35, specify the attachment point as 69, give some distance to where the slide position is, press OK and maybe specify the auxiliary member here. In the 33.0 version, I would use the rigid support, click on the rigid support, choose the internal support function here. Now I get the additional question about the base point. I again enter 69 and specify the distance of the sliding position here and keep the slide support. Again, the question about the auxiliary members, I will just confirm with the dimensions of the pipe. So now a similar concentration has been done on the couplings. Previously, there were the normal hinge, the internal friction hinge, the internal spring, and the internal friction support. And they are all now regrouped under the same symbol of couplings. And it depends on what features you want to activate, whether it's internally modeled as a linear hinge, a friction hinge, an internal spring, or internal frictional hanger. So if you just keep the ideal hinge, you have the 6 degrees of freedom that can be blocked or freed. If on top of that you want to consider a stiffness, you would have been using an internal spring, and in this internal spring you can specify the spring rates. And on top of that, you want to consider nonlinear effects like frictions or constant force. You would check the nonlinear button and can then add the additional features like friction or pressure-dependent friction. And finally, if you want to add some gap, you can also add two more columns for the gap. So if I have a look in the split screen mode here, I have now connected my structural steel with the rigid element to the pipe, and I want to model the connection first of all with the hinge. So I select the hinge symbol, I click on the node where I want to introduce it, and I have to select all the parts that are not coupled. So I would have to check these combinations and only keep the QZ coupled here. This would be the linear hinge. The same function in the new version, I will choose the coupling symbol. I click on the node and I say which directions are coupled now, and it would be only the QZ that is coupled. This would be again the linear hinge. If I want to insert stiffness in the 32.1 version, I would use an internal spring. So I now remove my boundary condition and I replace it by an internal spring. And in the internal spring, I have to give the spring rates in all directions. So if only the Z direction is coupled, I would just specify the Z direction here, and all other directions would be zero. That's 32.1. 33.0, I take the hinge function and now say consider stiffness and specify the stiffness which I want to enter here. 2000. Okay, and you can see that the symbol has automatically changed. The next part is if I want to add some friction, I would use the internal friction support. So again, I will use the remove boundary condition and replace it by the internal friction support. Now I'm asked for the displacement to be blocked. So again, WZ, and now I can give some friction here. Yeah. So let's check that here. In this case, I would say consider a gap and friction. And now I can specify here some friction, for example, 0.3 for the friction, and I can give some gap in the positive negative direction. And you can see that the symbol has again changed here. And the last functionality would be the internal frictional joint here. I would have to specify a new condition here for the Z direction, and now I can specify some stiffness and I can specify some additional load and maybe some pressure dependent loads. And in the new version, I would go to the node. I would specify that I want to have the stiffness and some nonlinear effects, specify the elastic stiffness here and maybe the additional friction in this window here. And I get my internal frictional hinge. Another reduction of the number of icons that was introduced with the new version is concerns the view toolbar. Historically, there were icons for small rotations. These now have been replaced by the mouse movements, and you can parameterize which mouse button should be attached to which function so that you can adapt your mouse functionality to whatever other tools, 3D tools you are using, to see which part will be the zooming button, which will be the shift or rotate button. On the other side, you can see all the different coordinate systems. They now have all been regrouped in a single symbol in the tool button bar, and with a submenu where you can choose which menu you want to have. In order to show this on the split screen view, I have to open up the old version because it takes too many icons here. So you can see all the different coordinate systems which you can bring up here from the different views. And the same functionality in the new version can be seen here. You just select the different coordinate systems from the drop-down icon bar here. The old rotate functions can now be just done with the mouse. This concludes my first part on the new version 33.0. Hope you tune in next time, and thanks for watching.